So now, Rinpoche is happy to answer any questions.
Yeah.
Okay.
From the audience?
Kwanzo, go grab somebody.
It's an excellent opportunity.
Okay.
Because Rinpoche will not always be here.
Okay. I think we are very lucky that Rinpoche is with us today, the whole day. And then so he would like to open this time up for any question from anyone here. 所以那个我们很幸运今天仁波切感谢仁波切跟我们一整天在这边听法那他说接下来这个时段呢任何人有任何的疑问都可以提出来仁波切会亲自回答大家的疑问那你们要问的要问问题的时候请讲大声一点 If you want to ask question, please speak loudly so we could hear.
我先问了，刚刚我们在喝茶的地方有看到一个嘎谦基金会，然后上面写个延续嘎谦佛学院的这些善业，那很想问问，也借这个机会让很多华人朋友，因为我们会透过电视让他们了解。 这个嘎谦基金会要做什么？那让他们有这个机会来种这个叫福田基金会。So
we were having tea earlier during the break, and I came across one information about Southwest Buddha Field Endowment Fund. And so I wonder what is that about. I wonder if Gachin Rinpoche could help us clarify what is the purpose of this endowment fund, and then what was the intention to do, how to continue Rinpoche's enlightened activity afterwards. And then it is important to explain this to the Chinese audience through TV broadcasting around the world, so more people could be aware and could possibly support this project.
nga yuna deni miyun gore deni tien ro kisa te miyun na minya to pesha yun gore te ki chuto de deni lungma de na pamjol la tin na khara so che gore ki nga mina deni mi mang mo mang ma go chuto de de to ka ma ri deni de deni che ta go ma ne go yo ri ma ne un ti chuto yun bo de to gore de de deni ta mo kusi la la we で、てらてたたんぼれて、ドムタンカで、て、マランケ、パイアニ、ニョネ。てて、ドムマンディ、カレラテネ、サマンサンケ、サムタ、テザルタンネ。てた、サマンサンケ、トトジ、てカデシャネ。カレ、ロバジャロテネ、サヤニウナ、てマンゴ、デトゴゾ、チキラテ、ミチラテネ。てらわらて、てて、ロマンサンケ。
So now the endowment fund is actually something that originated from the intentions of the disciples. And so what they have said is that when I'm here, then people are coming. And when people are coming, then also the money is coming, and then the center can stay. So of course the center also needs some financial resources in order to be able to survive in this country. So that is necessary. And then they were worried about that when I'm not here, then we would not have sufficient income to support the center. So maybe the center will close down in the future. And that is why they have said that we need an endowment fund by all means. We need some kind of foundation that we can draw on so that the center can remain for a long time in the future. And it was actually also Christina who also came up with that idea in the past. And what she did is she bought a Tara Tanka, the Tanka that we have here from Nepal. And it has many Tara images on it. And so then each disciple can sponsor one Tara image, for example. And in this way, slowly, we have been able to establish or create more and more money. So there's a total of $2 million that need to be raised, but we have not achieved that yet. And so they believe that if we have the $2 million as an endowment fund, then the center can remain in the future by drawing only from the interest rate from that endowment fund. So disciples have come up with various ideas, like the 37 practices garden and so on, and many different other methods or ways to raise money for the endowment fund, with the intention that the center can remain with stability in the future.
OK, 刚刚那个仁波切解释说，这个西南佛土基金会福田基金会的成立的缘由是主要是来自弟子的发心。那么弟子有这样子的念想，就是当我现在在世的时候，只要我在呢，弟子就会来，那这个中心自然就有财务上的资源能够让这个中心继续维持下去。可是这些弟子就担心，当我有一天不在这里的时候，如果说还没有足够的人来这个中心的话，中心的运行就没有办法维持，而可能必须要结束。所以他们希望说，我们在这边的一些佛行事业能够继续维持下去。那在过去呢 ，Christina 有这样的一个念想，所以他就制作了一个白杜姆的唐卡。那么从尼泊尔这边特别制作的一个白杜姆的唐卡。那就是说，如果弟子有捐特定的钱，他们可以认捐白杜姆唐卡里面的一尊白杜姆，然后多少钱来认捐，来支持这个福田基金会。那这个福田基金会的目标是希望能够筹到$2,000,000，那目前是还没有筹到$2,000,000，还站在努力当中。那这个是所谓的基金，就是不动用它的本金，我们是希望利用这个从$2,000,000的利息收入，可以帮助这个噶谦佛学院中心的营运跟的维持。那当然也有其他的方式来筹款，比如说有人想起来用佛子行37颂刻在石头上的这个碑林呢，是一种筹款的方式，还有其他的方式来筹款等等，都是这些弟子希望能够用有这个利用目前的这个机会来能够达到这个福田基金会一个目标这样子。
在了这里是说让一些那去做的别扎起我做个都那龙马今天就拼我那去做个拼个都那你这位这说说让那里去叫他扎起啊有大约的国际嘛都本来他的做法给我那你把这这个去做啊光去不这个大家去做的狼狗公的街啊我说大家去做的大家咖喱叫他咖喱去做的大家那些口罩介绍公了我用这些那里你要看云呐，说说龙巴卡啊，热腾啊，大天气，龙巴这里白沙土车的，就跟个南王朝有的，古巴跟南王有的，我现在的古巴卡上了，古巴那里白沙土里头，古巴这里怕不潮的，这个古巴这上头有的，这里龙巴这里白沙土车的，龙巴这里怕压的，就忙过了，就说。去做的叫这这些的，这些的为了新加坡，大华性质的去做，他也是他洛杉矶的所有的，这些东西这些的去做，开始做去做的，开始做通个都，这些个公平呀，这里，让王着我这个我说说龙巴这里去做了吧，这错的，你们那边下去做这个没？这里龙巴这里感觉到了龙巴这里怕这错的，往下做吧，那个这那个这里怕这，这里那个可可没？这里这里可是我心到不着急，这里这里讲啊，小气不没那样，可心的哦，他可是说就说没人找我送，这个也干啥干啥，就说要我的，开始查送，开始他们讲的有的龙巴说水，我们那上了这里的，那个就说要不看不透。本来那华盛顿、洛杉矶、阿哈里奥、
And so I personally consider the center as extremely precious, and that is because I really want to benefit this country, and in order to benefit this country, we need such a center. And for this reason, actually, I have also donated any of my precious objects, nice things that I have owned for the endowment fund. For example, there was this special watch I was given to by the Tara Foundation, and also I gave that to the endowment fund. So this is what I can do aside from spinning my prayer wheel. And so therefore, whatever I can, I'm trying to give as much as I can to the endowment. Maybe I can obtain it in a less costly way, so then the endowment fund really benefits from that. So, but basically, wherever I go, in the various places I go, all the donations that I receive, I actually always return that money back to that center, because Gar Monastery in Tibet actually does give me that freedom. So actually, whatever donations I have would go to the monastery, but the monastery's organization does give me the freedom to return the money that I receive to the centers that I'm visiting. So that is why I usually leave the money there with the intention to develop that center in the future. For example, there is the Singapore Center, or in Washington, in DC, or in Los Angeles, Ohio, and so on. And I'm also here. So all of these centers really benefit from that. So basically, I'm giving them whatever donations I receive, and I never take it with me. And when I do that, even though it's not so much maybe, but it also encourages the people there, and they feel inspired and to really maintain the intention, the goal that we have. And so there are some centers that have really turned out well, and some still have some difficulties, also depending on the situation in the country. But there's just a few who actually have physical premises, like the center here or in DC, in Los Angeles, in Ohio, in Germany. They actually have physical premises. And that is a great support for the disciples, because then also the disciples have a more stable place to go and practice. So that's really my goal behind all of that. Really, wherever I go, I want to establish the Dharma there, center there. That is my biggest hope.
那么我个人认为修习佛法有一个中心是非常重要，也是有一个佛法的中心是很珍贵的。那我不管到哪里都希望能够利益当地的这个国家，所以我希望说在不同的地方能有不同的中心。 所以呢，我经常把我自己所有一些比较宝贵的东西都捐出来给基金会，那么让他们帮助他们的筹款，包括从杜母基金会给我的一个很珍贵的表，我也捐出来让他们去筹款。那虽然我自己有个人的有条件的这种福报，但是我经常也用无时无刻的来要辗转经轮，希望说能够利益一些众生，而我所得到的一些捐款呢，我一般也都是交给中心，让他们留在当地能够就近利用。 那一般来讲呢，我们所生人所收到的钱，我们是要缴回去我们的寺院的。但是在康区的这个噶尔市呢，给我这样自由运用我所收到的捐款的这种条件，所以呢。 我到不同的东西中心去呢，包括不管是新加坡啊、华盛顿 DC 啊、洛杉矶，或者是俄亥俄州等等呢，我的一般我都把我收到的这个捐款呢或供养呢，都回馈，都回去交回去给当地的中心，能够利益他当地的社区跟中心。那么或许我收到的这个供养不是那么多，但是我希望我这样子的一种行为都是一种激励，对大家的激励，让他们能够继续为当地的这个中心来发心。有这些实质上的，有些中心有些僧团做得比较好，也有实质的这个中心的这种建筑物，比如说像这边亚利桑那州的嘎谦佛学院、华盛顿 DC、 洛杉矶中心、俄亥俄中心以及德国中心等等。那么这些有当地有这个实质的中心的地方呢，对于弟子来修行啊、修法都是一个非常大的一个支持。那所以以此之故，我无论我走到哪里，我都希望能够利益能够成立中心，能够利益当地的这个众生。
这样子呢，咱去做这么着的重要的，说说中国也就不满意吧。对去做一样的，做挂个给当人的，对他们被下搞个名的就叫冤枉的。错挂的因为总的这你错挂的这你妈这人家里头的把你给咋着我就空了外朋友错挂开始我妈说刚才没那这些人可错的样子这样的这些人家搞着都可以我们这么错挂刚刚是错挂的因为这人家他们家的错挂的朋友的这像不他们家的我的这里是。
And so I'm visiting all kinds of different centers. It's not just Jigong Kagyu centers. It's all kinds of Dharma centers and also other communities or organizations. And I find that there is really no place where people don't struggle financially. And mostly that is an issue. And so then, therefore, wherever I go, all the donations that I receive, I'm always offering that back to the center. As like my offering to them. And so then there are some places, some organizations, some centers who actually say then, actually we are doing fine, so you can take all those donations with you. And so when they say that, then happily and joyfully I'm taking that donations. But in any case, it is sort of my vow that I am always wanting to offer back what I receive from any center.
那么我也到不同的中心去讲法，不只是只供噶举传承的中心，甚至一些不同当地的文化活动中心我都有去讲。那有些地方的人士呢，他们的经济条件比较困难，所以在这种情况我往往也把我收到的供养回过来供养他们，那么帮助他们。那么有的除非有一些中心跟我讲说我们经济条件还可以维持，你没有必要把你得到的供养再给我们，在这种情况之下我也会很乐意的接受这个弟子给我的这个供养。那么这个就是我的一个誓言，就是希望能够利益一切的这个中心，尽量帮助他们。
所以借由今天这个机会，也透过电视台，透过网络，我想佛陀告诉我们什么都带不走，但是有一个永远不会坏的，就是福报。所以如果把世间不坚固的财来融入于三宝，特别是我们感谢仁波切的慈悲，为了利益众生，也让很多地区，特别边地欧美地区，有很多人可以学习佛法，所以那我们大家了解这个，大家一起来圆满这个福田。那以后呢，感谢仁波切成佛了，我们都有份，因为我们加入这个福田。阿弥陀佛。
Therefore, with the opportunity today, I would want to raise the awareness through the broadcasting of the TV, that as we learn from Buddha, that when we pass from this life, nothing we could bring with us. The only thing we could bring us is the karmic accumulation, including merit. And especially if we could integrate that into the triple gem and benefit others, that's even better, including those countries like in Europe, in America area, in American area, that people in those area could learn about Buddha Dharma. That is a great thing. So with this opportunity, I would like to encourage people to really support the Dharmic enlightened activity of Gachen Rinpoche, and we know his practice. One day when he became achieved Buddhahood, we could also receive a lot of benefit. Amitabha.
他们问问题.
Any question? 大家有什么问题请问? Any question for Rinpoche? Yes. 请大声一点讲, 所以我们可以听得到。 First of all, homage and prostrate to kind Guru Gachen Rinpoche, Master Haitao, and all the monastic member here. Rinpoche has given a teaching that we should treat all the disciples should treat their guru, their master, as if they are Buddhas. But I have a question. You also give a teaching that we should follow Dharma and not following individual. So how do we make the differentiation between Dharmic, following Dharma versus following individual? And how do we generate the motivation to have great devotion and firm faith towards our guru?
Rang
So actually, I would say that all the teachers, all the lamas are sangham. And now, in general, we might think that this is just in the Buddhist tradition only. But actually, also to me, it is that all the followers of any religion really are sangham. To me, that's how I see it. And so then nowadays in this world, often in the name of religion, we encounter both some faults and qualities. And so first of all, what is a sangha? A sangha is literally someone who delights in the practice of virtue. So then, what is virtue? It is that which brings benefit to yourself and happiness to others, or that which brings the temporary benefit and the ultimate happiness. And it is what brings that is the wish to, the loving wish to lead all sentient beings to a state of happiness. So in brief, we can say what we call virtue is love for all sentient beings. And that means to consider others as more important than oneself. And anyone who does that is a sangha. And actually, when you love others, that is really your own greatest benefit. If you don't think about yourself at all anymore, then this ice block of self-grasping will melt through the warmth of your love. So actually, by cultivating love for others, you are really actually doing yourself the greatest service, the greatest kindness really is towards yourself. It is your own greatest benefit, really, also. And so when you really cultivate love from the bottom of your heart, there is no wish for your own happiness. You just care about others, other sentient beings. And anyone who has that wish is a sangha. And if faults happen, then that fault is never the fault of the Dharma, but it is the fault of an individual. For example, even if you follow a certain religion and then one says, this is my religion, and my religion is better than other religions, then that kind of biased view leads to all kinds of negative thoughts of attachment and aversion. And it is based on a dualistic perception of self and other. And so that's the fault of that individual's mind and not the fault of the Dharma ever. And so, if you really understand that and have faith in the qualities of a sangha, then you will see any representation of the sangha as the embodiment of the three jewels. Then that person's form is the sangha, that person's speech is the dharma, and that person's mind is the Buddha. And so in this world nowadays, there's many different religions, and as we can see, there's faults and also qualities. But I never see the fault in the religion. The religion is always beneficial, and therefore, I feel that any religious practitioner is a sangham, and I feel like I'm taking refuge in them. So when we speak about the qualities of a Buddha, what is a Buddha? And that is quite difficult to understand, actually. A Buddha is basically one who has completely cleared away all selfish states of mind. There's no more self-grasping, and there is pure love for all sentient beings. And so because that is a mind of the Buddha, to me, actually, that is why Sangha is seen, should be seen as a Buddha, because that is what really most Sangha members have. They do have love for sentient beings. And because of that, we should see them as the Buddha, because that's the essence of the Buddha. And so then that kind of love that they have for sentient beings is like the love that a mother has for her child, her only child. If a mother only has one child, then that kind of love is the love that the Sangha or the teacher has for all sentient beings. And then all sentient beings, like the children, love them like their mother. So that kind of love, that's the kind of love that we have to develop. And then when we have that kind of love, that is why we call a teacher who has that kind of love as a Buddha. That's why we see them as a Buddha.
我们应该看一切的上师，不管是世间或者是出世间的老师，都把他们看成是僧团的一份子。那么，我们一切的弟子也都可以说是把他们看成是僧团的一部分。那因为个人的因缘不同，那可能有些过患，也可能有些功德。 所谓的僧团就是修行善业，所那的一个团体。那么，什么叫做善呢？也就是自利利他的行为。不管是为了自己，或者为了众生，能够带来暂时或者是就近的安乐，这都是善业。让众生能够安居住在那个乐当中，对众生充满了慈爱之心，这就是善的。甚至把众生看得比对自己更重要，这是一种无我的一个状态。如果能够这样子呢，那么我值得这种冰块呢，就能够透过慈爱心的暖热而消融。但是从另外一方面来讲， 我们虽然把重点放在利益他人，可是同时我们自己却是最大的利益承受者。当我们心里想到利他的时候，事实上我们也可以利益自己，这也就是僧团的另外一个特性。当然在这个生活上呢，有的时候僧团里面的分子会有一些有过患的地方，那一个人的过患并不代表这是一个僧团的这种过患，对这边我们要非常的清楚，个人跟团体之间的差别。有的时候有些人讲说我是这个宗教的信徒，我们这个宗教是最好的，其他的团体其他的宗教没有我们的团体，没有我们的宗教来好，像这种这个讲法并不是僧团的过错，也不是法的过错，这个乃是那个人个人的对于恶缘执着好坏对错的这种执着而有的这种过患。 我们要知道，一切僧团的代表是算是这个三宝的代表，外在的行为呢就算是僧宝，外在的言语呢就是法宝，僧团分子的内在的心念心事算是佛宝。那么，当然在这个世界上有各种的宗教。 有各种的不同修行的法门呢，那有些人会把它看作各有它的利弊，各有过患，或者是它的功德。可是对于我个人来讲呢，我没有见到他们的过患，因为一切的修行是为了这个僧团，为了利益众生而存在的，因此之故，我都皈依他们。 什么叫做佛呢？佛就是净化一切的我执，净化一切所有的一切自私之心，对于众生有纯净的这种慈爱之心。如果说一个人有这样子的心，我们就可以称他为佛，也就是这些人呢，对众生有清净的慈爱之心。那么就好像一个妈妈在慈爱她唯一的小孩一样。那从这个做出发点，这样的心态做出发。 点，然后扩大到对一切众生的这种慈爱之心，这就是佛。同相对的，小孩子父母亲对小孩子这么样的慈爱，小孩对母亲自然也有他们的爱。那 这种爱就好像对上师对佛的这种爱这样子的一般。
你们如果有问题要问法师也可以，if you have questions，你们可以直接问。我们的可以全部有人，你，咱们就把莫浪，啊，中中莫浪，啊，土康堂，上面我们的莫浪的还叫啥？全部的，这里已经开阳阳明，不是呢？莫浪的罗的这里，就是就啥子？咱们莫浪的地方被搞全部有人。
So also, since Rinpoche is here today, we have this excellent opportunity to also make prayers in his presence. And so we shall read the prayer, the King of Aspiration prayer for excellent conduct. And also there is the Shantideva Bodhicharya Vatara dedication. So depending on time, we will read one of those prayers. And these prayers in that book are really extremely precious. Actually, if you're not able to do any other practice, if you just recite these prayers, actually, these prayers will be accomplished because these are the aspirations of all the Buddhas of the three times. So they are very important.
那既然我们今天有海涛法师、仁波切在这里，我们应该善加利用这个时间。那在他的在他我在有他的这种情况之下，我们如果结束的之前有时间的话，我们应该念好好的来念一些祈愿文，来做很好的回向。比如说这个普贤恒愿品，或者是说入菩萨行论的回向品等等。那我们可以依我们自己有的，我们现有的时间来决定要念什么样的一个祈愿文。那么这个祈愿文对于过现未来三世都是非常好的。那中国的弟子，我们后面有中文的祈愿文，请麻烦去拿，在这个架子上面有一个 Chinese text 里面那个绿色的本子，是不是菩提要道，不是吗？不是吗？ Of course.
Is there still an opportunity to be part of liberating the cow? The cows that you're liberating, that you wanted to get to 500, and it sounds like you haven't quite met that goal. Is there a way for us to participate in that at this point?
He actually have actualized that, but then that's a good question to ask him. He actually has a... Well, let me just translate and let him respond.
Okay.
请问海涛法师，您早些时候您说要发心，要怎么讲，放生500头牛，那我们不知道是不是还有机会能够参与这样子的善行善举呢？还可以啊，现在是300多头，他们现在这个时间也开始在放。<laughs>
Of course, as of now, there are about more than 300 being liberated. And then as of now, at this moment, they are still trying to save some cows.
So would I talk to you, or some, who would I talk to about being a part of that, if I'd like to?
就跟你说就好了，因为今天是在藏地就12月初二了吧，所以今天功德日，他们有两种，一种是1000块人民币的，那是他们供养寺的喇嘛的家人，一种是丁山仁波切这边找外面的。 好像一头是2000人民币，如果他们要参加，就直接跟你说一下也可以。嗯哼，yeah，maybe
we could talk afterwards. That there are different ways that today is actually December 2nd in Tibet, and that is actually an auspicious day with all the merit would multiply so many times. And there are different groups that are releasing a cow at different amount. That one group is 1,000 RMB, that's the currency in China. And the other Dingzhou Rinpoche is 2,300 RMB. So I guess that people could, whatever resource you have, we could try that. Yeah, Yeah, if you have questions, you could talk to me and I will forward a question or request or your donation to them. Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you, Rinpoche.
Thank you, Rinpoche. No, it's just Chinese translation of the dedication prayers. Okay, maybe one last question and then we'll recite these prayers per Rinpoche's suggestion. 我们还有时间，或许还有时间问一个问题，然后接下来我们就问来念这些祈愿文。 有没有任何人对于海涛法师、海涛大和尚，或者是感谢仁波切有什么疑问，可以现在问，把握时间。
他的那个朋友因为告诉了他那些跟他的关系，然后还有其他朋友因为这个一些神通，然后就得到很多的对三宝的那种很大的那个信心。那仁波切，请问一下，用这种方式来普渡一些有缘的人，与神通有缘的众生，这样子是不是也是一个很好的善巧方便呢？
I first of all, I want to pay respect to Gachen Rinpoche and Master Haitao. Earlier, Master Haitao mentioned that one of his friends who practiced meditation and have the clairvoyant ability, and he was able to explain the relationship, a past life relationship between him and the people around surrounding him. And as a result, they generate more faith in Triple Gem. So my question is that, is this a skillful means for some of the people who have the connection through the clairvoyant ability, they will be able to use that as a skillful means to benefit people and lead them towards more faith to Triple Gem?
Both.
So there is some people who don't really believe in past and future lives, and then there are some who do understand that there are past lives. And so then if somebody does understand that, and then if that person who understands that there are past lives, if you there's a clairvoyant person who would tell them something, then the person would also trust them because they believe in past lives. And so then there's different kinds of connections that we have. What we have just been describing is more like a close connection that due to this close connection, like just from a previous life or so, a special feeling arises and we meet someone. And then on a larger scale, actually all sentient beings have been our parents in previous lives. But then often there is this close connection that we have from just a previous life where we have been, for example, somebody was our parent or our friend, our companion, and then a special feeling arises when we meet them, for example. And there's many stories about that. And so, for example, there's many people who actually even remember, can see what kind of family it is and what country it was and what was, who was the father and who was the mother, who was the husband, and so on. And so then basically when one knows that, then how it is utilized is that when one knows a past life, then the path that that should lead us onto is the path of karma, cause and effect. So then in that case, it's a good thing.
对于有些人呢，没有这种对于过去、现在、未来这种三世轮回啊，或因果的这种信念，那或许这些人透过其他能够看到三世的人呢，透过这种神通呢，他能够对过去、现在、未来的这种连结而能够相信这样子的一种状况。 那么我们事实上在这一个世界上，我们所遇到的人跟不同的人有不同程度的那个连结，因为过去世的关系有一种不同的连结。那刚刚提到的这个，因为我们过去世是父母也好、子女、家人等等的，我们有很紧密的连结，这叫做。 近的连接，那当我们在这一辈子遇到这些很有很近的连接的这些人呢，我们会对他们升起一种特别的这种感受。那么，事实上，我们广义的来讲，推广来讲呢，一切的众生都是我们过去世的父母。 但是就以近的这个连接来讲，对我们身边的一些特定的人，我们自然有特别的感受能够升起。对于这点呢，也有许许多多流传的故事，大家或许听过。有些人呢，他自己能够意念去过去世的父母，或者是丈夫、伴侣，或者是国家等等的。 那我们要知道，知道了这一些之后呢，我们如何能够把这个作为道用？我们那把可以了解说，这个道呢，主要是由业而来的这个因果的这种连结。有了这样子的理解之后，我们就知道该做什么事，该做什么样的行为。我想对我而言。 会升起责任感，因为，譬如说我可能是我的业吧，所以我旁边一直有人在告诉我，而且我也知道蛮正确的，因为他这个人动机人格要很重要，那只是让我知道。所以，譬如说在美国，我过去出事做什么做什么，我有一点知道，所以我来美国跟以前不知道不一样，以前是来玩的。 现在是来还债，也来负责任，心甘情愿。所以后来我就知道，我去的每一个国家，都是过去在那边投胎过。那边帮助我的人，都是过去跟我们有很深的因缘，包括害我的人。那我了解以后，我就告诉自己一句话：因为了解，所以慈悲。所以我就不会再怨任何一件事情。 我只能说，我努力的去偿还也好，我努力的去负这个责任也好，对我有帮助。但是我不认为每个人，有些人不应该去知道这个，因为他不相信因果，对他反而会有伤害。你要是绝对的相信因果，然后你去听，才不会对你有伤害。不然的话，你去问出你前世，那这个。 这个冤亲债主也会来找你，然后你反而会有很大的伤害。所以我想，就像波切讲，你的动机非常重要。知道以后，你愿不愿意去报恩、去还债，当做一种修行的道，这个是非常重要。只是我个人是因为这个因缘而很相信佛法，这是我个人的因缘。
As for me personally, knowing this is giving me a sense of responsibility. Perhaps it is my karma in the past that I always have people around me that has this clairvoyant ability. And I actually trust them because when I examine their behavior and their motivation, it's actually very positive and very it's trying to benefit others. And now that I'm learned more of my connection to the environment, to the people around me, it also changed my motivation whenever I visit different places and different country. For example, now I know my connection to this country, America, I have a different feeling. In the past, whenever I come, I have a sense of, oh, I'm just coming here to have fun. Just that it's a good journey. Now I know that whenever I come to America or go to other country, I know that I want to take on more responsibility. And it is time for me to repay what I owe people in the past. And the reason being that in the past, I have taken birth in different country. And then I know that some people that I owe them, and sometimes that people come to me and want to do harms to me. And then knowing the connection, knowing the cause and effect, I have no regrets and I have no grudge. And so there is a saying that due to understanding, therefore you have more loving kindness and compassion. So whatever happened to me now, I do not have the sense of resentment. I work very hard to try to repay whatever people's kindness or whatever I owe people in the past. However, that being said, for some people who do not trust in karma, who do not trust in the cause in effect, they probably should not know about their past life because these may bring some harm to them. If they do not believe, and now that they learn their previous life, they may feel that, oh, this is my karmic debt creditor who is coming after me. And then they may have additional struggle as a result. So as for me, as what Gachen Khan, Gachen Rinpoche just mentioned, my mindset is that I'm here to repay the kindness of Mother Sentient Beings, or I'm here to repay the debt I owe to Mother Sentient Beings. And this is my personal condition in this lifetime. It urged me to have even more faith and trust in Buddha Dharma and Buddha's teaching.
所以如果你心中还有一个强烈的爱或是恨，如果你知道了对你会有伤害，我有一个徒弟，然后他去问别人，告诉他那个女孩子过去是他的太太，后来他就还俗了，因为他不应该去问，所以我也知道，我就叫他你不要去碰这个事情。我有一次被害得很惨，因为我很喜欢真的想去救命去放生。 然后有一位出家人为了这个而还俗，搞了更大的团体来反对我，甚至登报纸找政府找我，我好像通缉犯一样。很多人就一直抱怨他为什么要伤害师父，伤害那么严重。但私底下我很尊敬他，因为他很聪明，跟我长得有点一样。但我心里会有点抱怨。那后来我不是求的，后来就是有一位来就跟我说，他说我跟你讲一个故事哦。 过去你跟他是兄弟，他要做皇帝的，结果你把他弄掉，换我做皇帝，所以他恨死你。哦，所以我知道以后，我一观察，怪不得兄弟长得一样，他真的是有那个帝王的味道。所以我从那天开始，我就完全不恨他，而且我对他很好，一直回向给他，一直对他很好。从那个时候开始，他就不再反对我了。<笑> 从来就不再反对了。那我觉得，当我因缘到了，我知道这个事情，也解决了我心里的问题，也解决了所谓救命的问题，他不再抗议了。所以我想， 佛菩萨会安排这个因缘，但是也不需要特别去求，但是至少你心中的一个痛苦就超越了，由恨就变成爱，我想这个是比较重要。
So when we have a strong emotion, such a very strong love, and then a very strong anger or hatred towards certain people, if you know the connection, sometimes it may harm us. For example, one of my disciples, someone told him about other people who being his wife in the past life, and as a result, he derobed, and then people like that, situation like that, maybe we should not know too much about past life when we have very strong love or hate. However, because I try to help people, I try to save lives, and sometimes it may have the opposite outcome, and someone derobe, and then other people, when they saw this, they are very upset, and so they accuse me make a big deal out of it, and then accuse me, make reports to the government. They even put it on a newspaper, on news media. So actually gave me a lot of stress. And so some of my students around me were very upset, and then thinking, how can they do this to harm you, Master? So I actually did not know what happened and why do people do that to me. And then again, someone with a clairvoyant ability around me told me a story and said, oh, maybe in the past life you are like siblings, and he's your younger brother, and then he wanted to be an emperor. But instead, you got rid of him, and then you became the emperor. And I was thinking, oh, no wonder we look so much alike in terms of our appearance. And knowing this, I know why he was so upset with me in this lifetime. So I dedicate all my practice and merit towards him. And very interestingly, after that, he stopped finding trouble in me, getting me into trouble. And so in this case, once we understand the past life connection, sometimes that it helps us resolve our issues that we encounter. So whether we should rely on these clairvoyant ability to know our past life connection, or how this would help us or not, we actually do not need to actively seek for them. Because Buddhas and Bodhisattva will have all these things arranged, and there's no need to actively look for them. And then what is important is that knowing some of the connection, knowing karma, knowing the cause and effect, would help us to transform some of our feelings, especially hatred, into love towards sentient being. And that part, this transformation, becomes something very important for us to learn.
所以我现在的了解是，只要你动机非常正确，护法神24小时都想要帮助你，这些菩萨们他会透过各种方式让你去了解，让你去超过那个痛苦。所以回过头来，就是保持一个真实的一个利他的菩提心，那你就会了解一点都不寂寞，你也不用特别去追求神通，因为很多事情都是变成一个最好的安排，这是最好的方法。
Now my realization, my understanding is that as long as you have the right motivation, then there are guardians around us. They would work very hard 24 hours around the clock to help us understand and to help us transform and overcome our suffering. And then, so
As long as we have the altruistic mind, this bodhicitta, there's no need to look for clairvoyant ability. And everything we should understand, whatever happened to us is the best arrangement for us.
Okay.
So because of the time, Rinpoche says we're going to do the Samantabhadra prayer now.
Samantabhadra. Puxianwang Rudai Xinyuan,
Page 40 in English.
Puxianwang Rudai Qiyuanwen, 这个中文是 30 页.
Do we read in Chinese or English?
More English speakers or more Chinese speakers?
Yeah, more English.
More English speakers.
So maybe we could read it in English and Chinese students could read it silently. Yes? 那因为我们在场有比较多的这个看英文的弟子，所以我们会这个念英文，然后中国学生自己看中文默念，好不好？ So then Rinpoche say that since we have more English readers, so we read it out loud in English, okay. And for Chinese students, you could just read Chinese silently.
So on page 40, in the prayer of Kuntu Sangpo. Home, everything, appearance and existence, samsara and nirvana, has a single ground, yet two paths and two fruitions, and magically displays as awareness or unawareness. Through Kundu Sangpo's prayer, may all beings become Buddhas, completely perfected in the abode of the Dharma Dhatu. The ground of all is uncompounded, and the self-arising great expanse beyond expression has neither the name samsara nor nirvana. Realizing just this, you are a Buddha. Not realizing this, you are a being wandering in samsara. I pray that all you beings of the three realms may realize the true meaning of the inexpressible ground. I, Kundu Sangpo, have realized the truth of this ground, free from cause and condition, which is just the self-arising awareness. It is unstained by outer expression and inner thought, affirmation or denial, and is not defiled by the darkness of unmindfulness. Thus, the self-manifesting display is free from defects. I, Kundu Sangpo, abide as intrinsic awareness. Even though the three realms were to be destroyed, there is no fear. There is no attachment to the five desirable qualities of sense objects. In self-arising consciousness free of thoughts, there is neither solid form nor the five poisons. In the unceasing clarity of awareness, singular in essence, there yet arises the display of the five wisdoms. From the ripening of these five wisdoms, the five original Buddha families emerge, and through the expanse of their wisdom, the 42 peaceful Buddhas appear. Through the arising power of the five wisdoms, the 60 wrathful Harukas manifest. Thus the ground awareness is never mistaken or wrong. I, Kundu Sangpo, am the original Buddha of all. And through this prayer of mine, may all you beings who wander in the three realms of samsara realize the self-arising awareness. And may your great wisdom spontaneously increase. My emanations will continuously manifest in billions of unimaginable ways, appearing in forms to help you beings who can be trained. Through my compassionate prayer, may all of you beings who wander in the three realms of samsara escape from the six life forms. From the beginning, you beings are deluded because you do not recognize the awareness of the ground. Being thus unmindful of what occurs is delusion, the very state of unawareness and the cause of going astray. From this delusive state comes a sudden fainting away and then a subtle consciousness of wavering fear. From that wavering, there arises a separation of self and the perception of others as enemies. Gradually, the tendency of separation strengthens, and from this, the circle of samsara begins. Then the emotions of the five poisons develop. The actions of these emotions are endless. You beings lack awareness because you are unmindful, and this is the basis of your going astray. Through my prayer, may all you beings recognize your intrinsic awareness. Innate unawareness means unmindfulness and distraction. Imputing unawareness means dualistic thoughts towards self and others. Both kinds of unawareness are the basis for the delusion of all beings. Through Gondo Sangpo's prayer, may all you beings wandering in samsara clear away the dark fog of unmindfulness, clear away the clinging thoughts of duality. May you recognize your own intrinsic awareness. Dualistic thoughts create doubt. From subtle attachment to this dualistic turn of mind, dualistic tendencies become stronger and thicker. Food, wealth, clothes, home, and friends, the five objects of the senses and your beloved family, all these things cause torment by creating longing and desire. These are all worldly delusions. The activities of grasping and clinging are endless. When the fruition of attachment ripens, you are born as a hungry ghost, tormented by coveting and desiring, miserable, starving, and thirsty. Through Gondo Sangpo's prayer, may all you desirous and lustful beings who have attachments neither reject longing desires nor accept attachment to desires. Let your consciousness relax in its own natural state, then your awareness will be able to hold its own. May you achieve the wisdom of perfect discernment. When external objects appear, the subtle consciousness of fear will arise. From this fear, the habit of anger becomes stronger and stronger. Finally, hostility comes, causing violence and murder. When the fruition of this anger ripens, you will suffer in hell by boiling and burning. Through Gondo Sangpo's prayer, you beings of the six realms, when strong anger arises for you, neither reject nor accept it. Instead, relax in the natural state and achieve the wisdom of clarity. When your mind becomes full of pride, there will arise thoughts of competition and humiliation. As this pride becomes stronger and stronger, you will experience the suffering of quarrels and abuse. When the fruition of this karma ripens, you will be born in the God realm and experience the suffering of change and falling to lower rebirths. Through Gondo Sangpo's prayer, may you beings who develop pride let your consciousness relax in the natural state, then your awareness will be able to hold its own. May you achieve the wisdom of equanimity. By increasing the habit of duality, by praising yourself and denigrating others, your competitive mind will lead you to jealousy and fighting. And you will be born in the jealous God realm where there is much killing and injury. From the result of that killing, you will fall into the hell realm. Through Gondo Sangpo's prayer, when jealousy and competitive thoughts arise, do not grasp them as enemies. Just relax in ease, then consciousness can hold its own natural state. May you achieve the wisdom of unobstructed action. By being distracted, careless, and unmindful, your beings will become dull, foggy, and forgetful. By being unconscious and lazy, you will increase your ignorance, and the fruition of this ignorance will be to wander helplessly in the animal realm. Through Gondo Sangpo's prayer, may you beings who have fallen into the dark pit of ignorance shine the light of mindfulness and thereby achieve wisdom free from thought. All you beings of the three realms are actually identical to Buddhas, the ground of all. But your misunderstanding of the ground causes you to go astray, so you act without aim. The six karmic actions are a delusion like a dream. I am the primordial Buddha here to train the six kinds of beings through all my manifestations. Through Gondo Sangpo's prayer, may all you beings without exception attain enlightenment in the state of Dharma Dhatu. Aho, hereafter, whenever a very powerful yogin with his or her awareness radiant and free from delusion recites this very powerful prayer, then all who hear it will achieve enlightenment within three lifetimes. During a solar or lunar eclipse, during an earthquake or when the earth rumbles, at the solstices or the new year, you should visualize Gondo Sangpo And if you pray loudly so all can hear, the beings of the three realms will be gradually liberated from suffering through the prayer of the yogin and will finally achieve enlightenment.
Thank you, 我也谢谢你 阿比尔参加, thank you.
Yeah.